Don't sell me away from my baby. Don't take him away from me. He only 1 year old. Mama, don't. I mean, Massa, don't. Massa, please. Please. I now smile at the artist. Leon, the artist. Born in what once was the slave capital of Alabama. Born where in 1901, blacks could not be seen after 10 p.m. in Montgomery. Born in a city that was not kind to Rosa Parks and her husband Raymond. A city that forced her to work and to find work in Detroit, where 40 years later, she died. Leon, born in Montgomery, where the newest black museum on lynching stands, and what once was the place where the enslaved were kept before they were sold. I now smile again at the artist. Leon, the artist. I smile. Why? Because he's free to paint where he wants, what he wants. Not forced like Pittsburgh-born black artist Henry Ossawa Tanner to live in Paris from 1891 till his death in 1937. Not forced like Florence, South Carolina-born black artist William Johnson to live in Denmark till he died in Long Island in 1970, 25 years in a mental institution. I smile. Because your artfully painted landscapes are your voice. Your artfully painted oil portraits are your cry. Your voice, your cry. Tell the world, look at me. My eyes saw this. My hands drew this. There is freedom in my art. And as we know, freedom ain't never really free. I say freedom ain't never really free. I say freedom ain't never really free. If you want the peaches, I say if you want the peaches, I say if you want the peaches, you gotta shake the tree. This artist shook it, still shaking it, finding his freedom called art.